Hi students, welcome to Justin NCERT Solutions. In this video we are going to see 7th standard maths chapter 2 exercise 2.7 5th question. And here we are going to divide a decimal number by another one decimal number. The first question, we are going to take first sum 7 divided by 3.5 is equal to 7 divided by 3.5, and here decimal point is there. To remove this decimal point, we are going to multiply by 10 by 10. Then we will get whole number in the denominator also. So 7 into 10 is equal to 70 divided by, and here 3.5 into 10, it will become as 35. And now we can simplify. 135 is 35, 235 are 70. So the answer is 2. 7 divided by 3.5 is equal to 2 is answer. And then second question, 36 divided by 0.2 is equal to 36 divided by 0.2, and to remove this decimal point we are going to multiply 10 by 10. Why we are multiplying by 10 by 10? Because we have only one decimal part is there, that's why we are multiplying 10 by 10 is equal to, now 36 into 10 is equal to 360 divided by 0.2 into 10 is equal to 2. This decimal point is moved right hand side, so answer is 2. And when we are simplifying, 1, 2 is 2, here 18, 2s are 36, and here 1, 0, so the answer is 180. And third question, 3.25 divided 0.5 is equal to 3.25 divided by 0.5 is equal to, and here 3.25 in the denominator 0.5 is there. To cancel this decimal points, we have to multiply and divide by 100 by 100. We can do it in two methods. To remove only the decimal part in the denominator, if you want to cancel in the denominator alone, we have to multiply only 10 by 10. We are going to cancel both decimal parts, so we are going to multiply by 100 by 100 is equal to, here 325 divided by, now we multiply with 2 zero, so it will become 50. Here two decimal parts moved right hand side, and here also two decimal places, but we have only one decimal, so another one we added as a zero. Now 325 divided by 5, we have to simplify. 5, if you are simplifying, 10 5s are 50, and in 32 we have 6 5s are 30 remaining 2, so 25 is there, 5 5s are 25. Now we have 65 divided by 10, 65 divided by 10, now we don't have any problem, we have only one decimal, only one zero is there, so automatically we can write it 6.5, because in the denominator if we have only one zero, we have to make only one decimal part, so answer is 6.5. for third question answer is 6.5. and now fourth question, 30.94 divide 0.7 is equal to 30.94 divided by 0.7. Here also 1, 2 decimal places. So we are going to multiply and divide by 100 by 100. Now this will become 2 digits. We are moving right hand side because we are multiplying with 100. 2 zeros are there. So 2 decimal points we are going to move right hand side. So this will become 3094 divided by. Here only one decimal part is there. We have to make 2 decimal part. So we are added 0 here. 70. We have to divide this 3094 divided by 70. Now 3094 by 70. In 30 we don't have any other 70. So we are taking first 3 numbers. In 309, how many 70s are there? If we are taking, if we are multiplying by 4th table, 4 7s are. If we are multiplying by 4th table or 7th table, 4 7s are 28. So 4, 280 divided by. What is remaining? 9 minus 0 is equal to 9. Here 30 minus 28 is equal to 2. Next we are taking this 4 also. 294. In 294 again we have 4. 4 sevens are 28. 280. Remaining 14. Now we cannot divide because then we are going to make 1 0 and decimal part. Decimal part, here we added 0, now 270s are 140, remaining 0. So the answer is 44.2 is answer for 4th question. Now 5th question, 0.5 divided 0.25 is equal to 0.5 divided by 0.25, and in the denominator we have 2 decimal places, so we are going to multiply by 100 by 100 is equal to, here we have only 1 decimal part, so we are adding 1 0. Now 50 divided by, here we have 2 decimal places, so we are moving the decimal part to here. So this answer is equal to 25. Now 50 divided by 25 is equal to 2. 125 is 25, 225 is 50. So 5th question answer is equal to 2. Now we are going to solve 6th sum. Sixth sum is equal to 7.75 divided by 0.25 is equal to 7.75 divided by 0.25. Here in the numerator and denominator both also having 2 decimal places. So we are going to multiply and divide by 100 by 100 is equal to, when we are multiplying by 100 according to the number of zeros we have to move the digits. So here, from here we are going to move the decimal part to here. 775 divided by, this decimal part move right hand side 2 steps, so this is become 25. So in 775, how many 25s are there? 775 divided by 25. In 77 we have 325, so 75 and remaining 2 and this 5 we have taken. Now 125 is there, remaining 0. So the answer is 31. 775 divided by 25 is equal to 31. And 7th question, 76.5 divided by 0.15 is equal to 76.5 divided 0.15 multiply. In the denominator we have 2 decimal places, so we are going to multiply and divide by 100. 100 divided by 100. Now we have to move two steps right hand side. So 7650. Here we have only one decimal place, so we are adding another one. So 50 is there. Now 0.15 is there. Two steps we have to move right hand side, so no problem. We have two decimal places. We moved means the answer will become as whole number 15. Now we are going to divide 7650 divided by 15. How many 15s in 76? In first number 7 we cannot divide, so we are taking two numbers. In 76, how many decimal places? We have 5 15s are 75. 5 5s are 25, remaining 2, 5 1 is 5, 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. So 75, remaining 1. And here we are taking next number 15. 1 15 is 15, and next number is 0, so we add 0 here and 0. Here we have taken 0. Here we have only remaining number is 0. You can add it here. Otherwise, just multiply this number, then you can add 0 in the quotient. Now the answer is 510. For 7th question, answer is equal to 510. And last 2 questions, 8th question and 9th question. Eighth question 37.8 divided by 1.4 multiply. We have only one decimal places in numerator and denominator also. So 10 divided by 10 is equal to, when we are multiplying, only one step is moved, 378 divided by one step moved right hand side, 14. 378 divided by 14. In 37, how many 14s we have? 2 14s are 28. And remaining 7 minus 8 we cannot subtract. So we are borrowing from here. So now 17. 17 minus 8 is equal to 9. Now we are taking this 8. In 98, how many 14s we have? In 19, you can use the 14th table. 7 4s are 28, remaining 2, 17 is 7, 7 plus 2 is equal to 9, 98, remaining 0. So now we have number 27 as a quotient. 27 is answer for 8th question. Next, 9th question, 2.7573 divided 1.3 is equal to, we are dividing 2.73 by 1.3 multiply. We have two decimal places in the numerator, so we are going to multiply by 100 and dividing by 100 is equal to two decimal places, so we are moving two steps right hand side. 273 divided by, here we have only one decimal place, so we are adding another one, 0. 130. Now 273 divided by 130. In 273 we have 230s are there, because 260 will come. 2 13s are 26 and 0 is there, so 260 divided, that remaining 3 minus 0, 3, 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. We cannot divide this 13 by 130. So we are making decimal part, decimal point. Now we are adding 0. In 130, 130 is there. So 1. The answer is 2.1. For 9th question, 2.73 divided by 1.3 is equal to 2.1. Well, that's all students. Kindly give your suggestions in the comments box and share it with your friends and subscribe our channel. Keep supporting. Thank you.